All right, get out your lecture notes and let's build on what you've learned about process costing systems. Kinzen Industrial Corporation uses the weighted average method in its process costing system. During April, the micronizing department began with 5,000 units in process that were 90% complete as to direct materials, 60% complete as to direct labor, and 45% complete as to manufacturing overhead costs. The micronizing department completed processing of 20,000 units and transferred them to the next department. The cost of beginning inventory and the cost added during April amounted to $497,000 in total. The ending inventory in April consisted of 10,000 units, which were 90% complete with respect to materials, 40% complete with respect to direct labor, and 30% complete with respect to manufacturing overhead. The accountant computed the cost per equivalent unit for the month as follows. The cost per equivalent unit for direct material is 5, direct labor 7, factory overhead 8. So this problem starts us partway through the process. They've already calculated the equivalent units and then the cost per equivalent unit. First, we're asked to compute the cost of the ending work in process in the micronizing department and the cost of the units transferred to the next department. So first, we'll look at ending work in process inventory. And remember, when you value ending work in process inventory, be sure that you value equivalent units. You're going to want to assign direct material, direct labor, and overhead to those units. And remember, we had 10,000 units in ending work in process, but for materials, those 10,000 units were 90% complete. So we can say that there were 9,000 equivalent units as to material. And remember that the accountant calculated the cost per equivalent unit to be $5. So these 10,000 units will have $45,000 of materials assigned to them. For labor, those same 10,000 units were 40% complete, given in the problem. So we have 4,000 equivalent units. The labor cost per equivalent unit was computed to be $7 by the accountant. So those 10,000 units have $28,000 worth of labor assigned to them. And then for overhead, the 10,000 units were only 30% complete. So that translates to 3,000 equivalent units. The cost per equivalent unit as to overhead is $8. So the overhead cost associated with those 10,000 units is 24,000. So if we add all of these up, the direct material, the direct labor, and the overhead cost assigned to the 10,000 units that were partially completed, you can see that the total value of the ending work in process is $97,000. We were also asked to value the 20,000 units that were completed and transferred to the next department. And with that, I'll remind you of what was given. All of this information is given, but what we're going to concentrate on is the direct material cost of $5 per equivalent unit, direct labor of $7, and factory overhead of $8. To value the units completed in this department, we can add 5 plus 7 plus 8 and get a total cost per equivalent unit of $20. So to value the units completed in the micronizing department, we'll take the 20,000 units that are 100% complete as to direct materials, direct labor, and overhead, and we'll multiply by the cost per equivalent unit of $20. This will give us a value of $400,000 assigned to the units transferred. Now the second thing we're asked to do is show a cost reconciliation schedule for April. And this is where you will want to just look at what happened to the costs. So I remind you of what's given. The cost of beginning inventory and the cost added during April amounted to $497,000 in total. So that's both of those together. They did not separate it out for us. So when we go to look at where the costs are, we know that beginning costs are not given and current costs are not given, but we are told that they add up to $497,000. So again, the individual amounts are not given, but we don't really need it since they calculated the cost per equivalent unit for us. Then we'll look at where that $497,000 of cost was assigned. Value of ending work in process we calculated to be $97,000. The value of the units completed we calculated to be $400,000. So the cost that was accounted for is $497,000. You can do this in columnar form like this, or you could use an equation, but what it's trying to show is that you have taken the costs incurred, beginning and current, and assigned it to either the units completed or the units that you're still working on. All right, that's the end of the example, so be sure to bring questions to class. See you then.